Hello everyone, welcome to Hello Friends Chemistry channel. My name is Uma Shankar. In this video I am going to talk about chemical kinetics class 11. The topic is effect of temperature on rate of reaction. The topic is the Arrhenius equation. This is the very important concept in competitive exams. Now start this section, see this board friends. The concept is the Arrhenius equation. Friends, Arrhenius equation, this is the exact method for the rate of reaction and temperature. Now what is Arrhenius equation? Arrhenius equation, rate constant K is equal to A dot e power of minus Ea by RT. This is called as Arrhenius equation. Now K is called as rate constant, and A is called as Arrhenius factor or frequency factor or free exponential factor. Friends, is this A is called as Arrhenius factor or frequency factor or free exponential factor. This Ea is called as activation energy. What is friends? Ea is called as activation energy. This activation energy is the units, is the joules per mole. And this E is called as exponential constant. R is called as, friends, R is stands for universal gas constant. Friends, R is called as universal gas constant. This constant value is the 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin. This is the, in terms of energy, universal gas constant value is 8.314 joules per moles. This is the gas constant. Temperature in Kelvin. T is called as temperature in Kelvin. Okay friends, this is the Arrhenius equation. This is the exact method for the temperature and rate constant. Temperature is increases, automatically rate constant is increases. This equation is the exact method for the temperature, effect of temperature on rate of reaction. Now how to derive this Arrhenius equation in collision theory? Now this collision theory is very important concept. Now what is collision theory? This is clear friends. First of all, these points is note. Friends, this is clear friends. This is arise. Friends, derive the Arrhenius equation in collision theory. Collision theory. Friends, collision theory is explained to the molecules that collide to each other to give a product. Now we have to consider a reaction. The reaction is the A2 plus B2 is gives 2AB. This is the reaction friends. This A2 plus B2 is collide with each other to give you a product. The product is called is AB. Now one more important point friends, the point is the 1 second per unit volume, 1 second per unit volume, number of collisions, that is called as collision frequency. Okay friends, what is collision frequency? Per second per unit molecule of cube, that is called as collision frequency, that is denoted to the ZAB. Now collision theory is explained to the collide of the each molecules, but one more important point, not all collision between reactant molecule are effective collision. This is very important friends. Friends, not all collision between the reactants molecules have effective collision. Effective means it gives products. It gives products. This is very important, friends. Friends, collision theory is explain them. Not all collision molecules do not have a gives a product. Those molecules gives product. Now that is called as effective collision. For effective collision, not all collision between the reactants molecule to give a product. That is called as effective collision. What is effective collision? Effective collision is the two important condition that is called as proper orientation of reactant molecules, and second one is the orientation of energy barrier. This is very important, friends. First one is the orientation barrier. Orientation barrier, friends, this is the first one. Effective collision, first one is the orientation barrier. What is orientation barrier, friends? Now we have to give a reaction. The reaction is A2 plus B2 is gives 2AB. Now A2 molecule is like this. This is the A molecule and this is A molecule and this is B2 molecule like this. This is A2 molecule and this B2 molecule is collide to each other like this. In this orientation, it give you a product. It give you a product like this. This is the A B product and this is the AB product. In this orientation, now this orientation is called as add-on collision. And what, friends? This is called as add-on collision. Add-on collision of the molecules to give a product. This orientation is called as effective collision. This is called as effective collision. This is called as, friends, effective collision. In this orientation is, this molecule, A molecule is like this, B molecule like this. This orientation, it means these molecules is collide to each other in add-on collision. This is called as effective collision. This effective collision is the proper orientation to give a product like this. But you know that in this collision, in this molecule is like this. This is the A molecule is like this and B2 molecule is like this. This B molecule and this B molecule, this A molecule is collide to B molecule like this, but this A molecule is cannot collide with B molecule. This molecule cannot give a product in these molecules is reacted to each other, cannot give a product. This type of orientation is called as improper orientation. It means improper orientation, it means no effective collision. That is called as no effective collision. Now first one is the orientation barrier. This orientation barrier, it means the effective collision takes place. Effective collision means the molecules is collided with each other in proper orientation. It means add-on collision takes place to give a product. But in case improper orientation molecules, the molecules cannot give a product. This is the first one is the orientation barrier. It means improper orientation. Okay, friends, this is clear, friends. This is arise. And second important condition in collision, effective collision, the condition is the energy barrier. To cross the energy barrier, that is the effective collision takes place. Now this is clear, friends. This is arise. Friends, this is very important. The second condition is the energy barrier. First one is the orientation barrier in effective collision. This is the energy barrier. Now, energy barrier. Now, I am draw a graph for the energy barrier is like this. Okay, friends, this is called as in x-axis I am represented to the reaction coordinate, and y-axis I am represented to the energy. Okay, friends, this is a reaction coordinate and energy. Now in initial, the reaction coordinate is reactants and product. Okay, friends, this is the reactants and product. Now, this is called as energy barrier. This is called as energy barrier. This is called as energy barrier. Now, energy barrier to cross the reactant molecules to give you a product, that is called as the effective collision. Now, effective collision of this is the reaction coordinates and energy. This is the reactants. This energy is called as reactant energy is called as ER. This is the energy of reactants. This is called as EP. This is the product energy. Friends, you know that in this case, what happened, friends? In this case, reactants is a some energy. Reactants is a some energy. In reactant is some energy. Reactant is some energy. To gain a some energy of the reactants, already reactant is some energy. To gain a reactants in some energy, to cross the this energy barrier, that energy is called as activation energy. That energy is called as activation energy. Friends, reactant is already, reactants is having a some energy, and the minimum energy is required to the reactants. Reactant is already some energy. This reactants is cross of the this energy barrier. That energy is called as activation energy. In this energy is called as activation energy. Now, this total energy is also called as total energy is also called as threshold energy. That is called as ET. Friends, what is threshold energy? The total energy is also called as threshold energy. This energy is called as activation energy. Reactant is already some energy, and the minimum amount of energy is required to the reactants. This reactant is cross of the this energy barrier to give you a product. This is called as activation energy. But in this case, reactant energy is less in product energy. Product energy is I. Now, this type of product energy is I with compared to the reactants. This type of reactions is called as endothermic reaction. This graph is represented to the endothermic reaction, friends. Endothermic reaction. Endothermic reaction, product energy is more. Product energy is more in with compared to the reactant energy. Now, this is called as activation energy. This is called as threshold energy. Friends, in activation energy is equal to them ET minus ER. ET minus ER. Now, this EA is called as activation energy. This ET is called as threshold energy. And ER is called as reactant energy. Friends, in reactants is gained to the some energy to cross a this energy barrier. Now, these molecules is the effective due to the effective collision. This is the basic concept of the effective collision. What, friends? Effective collision is important in to cross the energy barrier. It means the minimum amount of energy is required to the reactants in activation energy. This activation energy of the molecules to cross the this energy barrier. Now, these molecules is due to causes of effective collision. This is clear, friends. This is the graph representation of the energy versus reactants coordinates. Now, this is clear, friends. This is arise. Friends, one more important graph. Friends, one more important graph. I am represented to the graph of the one more important graph. The graph is the fraction of molecule and kinetic energy versus fraction of molecules. I am represented to the graph kinetic energy and fraction of molecules. The graph is like this is the graph, friends. This is the graph represented to the kinetic energy and fraction of molecules. Now, friends, in fraction of molecules, kinetic energy is like this. And some fraction of molecule kinetic energy is like this. And some fraction of molecule kinetic energy is like this. And some fraction of molecule kinetic energy is like this. And some fraction of molecule kinetic energy is like this. This is called as activation energy. It means this is called as energy barrier. This is the reactant molecule, some fraction of molecule kinetic energies like this. This EA is called as activation energy. It means energy barrier. Now what happened, friends? This is called as fraction of molecules is crossed to the energy barrier. This is called as fraction of molecules is crossed to the energy barrier. This point is called as probability of energy for fraction of molecules like this. Okay, friends. Now what is, friends, these molecules? Now these fraction of molecules is causes to them in this activation energy. This fraction of molecule energy is equal to the activation energy, and this fraction of molecules energy is greater than this activation energy. This fraction of molecules energy is equal to the activation energy. This is the orientation of the fraction of molecule versus kinetic energy at temperature T1 like this. But in case at temperature T2, friends, in case at temperature T2, the graph is like this. It means this is the T2 and this T2 is greater than T1. In this case, T2 is the fraction of molecules is like this. It means fraction of molecules is increases. What happened, friends? Rate of reaction is increases. It means speed of the reaction is increases of this graph represents kinetic energy and fraction of molecules at temperature T. The fraction of molecules, it means FOM, fraction of molecule cross to the energy barrier. It means energy barriers means activation energy. The crosses to the fraction of molecules in the energy barriers is equal to the e power of minus EA by RT. It means the fraction of molecules cross to the energy barrier, it means activation energy is crossed to the fraction of molecules. This is equal to the e power of minus EA by RT. This fraction of molecules is the increases. What happens when temperature is increases? Fraction of molecules is increases. It means rate of reaction is increases. Now the rate is directly proportional to the in this term. This term is called as e power of minus EA by RT. Now the rate is directly proportional to the rate constant. Now k is directly proportional to the e power of minus EA by RT. Now what happened, friends? K is equal to A into e power of minus EA by RT. This is called as Arrhenius equation. Now Poisson theory is explained that the fraction of molecules is crossed to this energy barrier. Now this is the T1 temperature, the fraction of molecules is like this. At T1 temperature, the fraction of molecules is like this, and T2 temperature, fraction of molecules is like this. Because of the fraction, temperature is increases. What happens, friends? Fraction of molecules is increases of this unit area. Now this is the graph representation of the kinetic energy versus fraction of molecules. Now this fraction of molecules is cross of the energy barrier. This is equal to the e power of minus EA by RT. Now the rate is directly proportional to this term. Now rate constant is directly proportional to this term. K is equal to A dot e power of minus EA by RT. This representation is called as, this is Boltzmann distribution law. This representation is called as Boltzmann distribution law. Then that Boltzmann scientist was proposed this concept. Now this equation is called as Arrhenius equation. This is the concept of the Arrhenius equation. Okay, friends, if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.